I'm Rajit Roshan from WSO2 APIM Energy team. In this tutorial, I will briefly describe the Advanced Throttling Policies which was introduced with WSO2 APIM Energy 2.0, the latest and the greatest. Now I will demonstrate how to add Advanced Throttling Policies using admin portal of WSO2 APIM Energy. First, let me log in using admin credentials. Once you logged in, you can see throttle policies in the left side menu. Click on Advanced Throttling tab in order to view the available Advanced Throttling policies. Then click on Add Tier to add new tier. First, let me provide the tier name and the description. So this version onwards, we allow throttling based on request bandwidth as well. That means the amount of data transferred through gateway per unit time. So this will offer an advantage to users who have throttle requirements with bandwidths. Especially if we have file download APIs or file upload APIs, this will be very much useful. Apart from this, that request bandwidth based throttling can be applied at application level, subscription level and API level as well. For example, if you want to limit the throttling based on bandwidth, so let's say if you want to limit 5 kilobytes of data per unit time for 1 minute, so you can provide data 5 kilobytes and specify the time as 1 minute. Conditional groups are the key in order to define advanced throttle policies. In conditional groups, what we do is we extract specific attributes from the message and apply throttling based on that. So this can be defined as content-based throttling as well. So in conditional groups, we allow throttling based on the particular IP or IP address range, based on the headers present in the message, and based on the query parameters present in the request. Apart from that, we also provide throttle based on the JWT claims as well. So in order to enable these conditional groups, we have to provide specific configuration in the API Manager XML. So you can find the API Manager XML in repository conf directory of your server home. So first you need to enable JWT generation. So you need to set this parameter to true. Apart from that, we need to provide these configurations as well in the API Manager XML. We need to enable these conditions. So then restart the server. So then you can apply those conditional groups to your particular tier. Now I will briefly explain each of these conditional groups. In IP condition, we allow throttling based on a particular IP address or IP address range. Let's say if we have a trusted client, we can allow more requests or more bandwidth for that particular client for a particular API. So we can specify the client's IP address here, and we can allow the request count or the request bandwidth in the execution policy area. And again, we can allow throttling based on IP address range as well. Let's say if a particular subset of clients in a particular subnet which use a particular API more, so we can allow them more number of requests by specifying the IP address range here. So again, you can specify the execution policy here. The header conditions allows you to throttle based on the headers present in the message. For example, if you want to limit a request from a mobile client for a particular API, then you can use this header condition. If you want to limit a request from a mobile client, then you can specify the user agent header here and give a particular regex to as the parameter value. So here I have specified that request coming from a mobile device from a Chrome browser here in this regular expression. So you can limit the number of requests from that mobile device using this header condition. Apart from that, you can also define any other header parameters. So example, if you want to limit the parameter header containing application JSON, you can give the content type as application JSON. The query parameter conditions allow you to limit requests based on the query parameters that appears in the message. For example, if you have an API which used to place orders, then you can limit the request for a particular item based on its availability. Let's say if a particular item is less available, then you can limit the request for that particular item. You can specify the parameter name as item and give the any value of the item. Then you can click on add. So the when you specify the request count and the time here, then the request for that particular item will be limited. API manager passes attributes of the API invoker to the backend implementation in order to authenticate users. These attributes are represented as claims in a JSON web token. So in order to apply throttling based on these claims, we need to use JWT claim condition. Let's say for an example, there is an API which is specifically used by a particular age group, then you can allow more requests for that particular age group. In order to do that, you can get the user JWT from the access token and then get the user's age from that token. So these are the default claims that is passed within the JWT. So in order to give a particular value, you need to give the full claim URL. So I can limit for a particular subscribers. Let's say if I have a subscriber called John, then I can limit the API invocations for that particular subscriber using this JWT claim condition. Well, the cool thing about these conditional groups is we can specify multiple conditional groups. For example, let's say if we want to provide a certain IP address range a certain number of requests and another IP address range another amount of requests, so we can add multiple conditional groups. So here I have specified this IP range of 5 requests per 1 minute, and then we can add another conditional group specifying another IP address range . So in this IP address range I can allow more number of requests. So this is another cool thing about conditional groups. So when a particular condition is met, these execution policies will override the default limits here. So when a particular IP address range matches any of these given conditions, it will override these default limits. I have defined some example advanced throttling policies which I will be using in my existing API. So I will go each one of them. In the Chrome based one, I have used and conditional group which is based on the header condition. So it checks for the user agent header and it blocks a request from Chrome browser. And another one is JWT based, so it looks for the JWT condition and checks if it has this subscriber. And another one is parameter based, so I have given a particular value for that for a parameter name when invoking my example API. Now I have a sample API which do simple basic mathematical operations. In this API you can see I have assigned the advanced throttling policies I have defined earlier. In the manage tab you can see per resource I have assigned those advanced throttling policies. For add operation, I have defined parameter based one. For multiply, I have defined JWT based. And for subtract, I have defined Chrome based advanced throttling policy. So let's try these invoking these operations one by one. So I'll first invoke add operation with parameter A set to 0. So this should block me after some number of requests. As you can see, the request say the response says you have exceeded your quota, because this is the parameter value for A is 0. Now let's try invoke multiply operation, which is again based on the JWT based. So for the particular user, it should block my request after certain number of invocations. As you can see that it says you have exceeded your quota. Again, in subtract also I have defined Chrome based one, so it will also limit my number of invocations per minute, because of I am invoking this using a Chrome browser. So that's the basic description about advanced throttling policies, which was introduced with API Manager 2.0. Thank you.